Toy Soldiers HD is coming to Xbox One, Nintendo Switch, PlayStation 4 and Steam. We're going to give you a quick preview, starting with the very first level of the game, Landmark 1914. Now, if you've never played Toy Soldiers before, the goal is simple. In each level, defend your toy box from the oncoming waves of enemies. To do so, you must fill the battlefield with various different types of units that you can control and upgrade in order to stop the enemies in their tracks. So I've placed a couple of level 1 machine guns here, and I'm actually going to go in and take control of this Vickers machine gun so that I can be in charge of this battle. I'm going to start taking on these advancing enemies in third person camera mode, and this is one of the most satisfying elements of the game, that seamless transition from top down strategic view into third person action view. And you'll notice that here, for certain actions I'm actually earning money. This will go into my bank, and that is what I will use to upgrade and buy units as I move ahead. So for example, here in this empty spot, I can't afford to put a mortar, so I'm going to put in another machine gun, and this will help me catch these guys that have managed to sneak past my first line of defense. Waves of enemies will get stronger as the level unfolds, and you can either wait for them to launch automatically, or if you're impatient, looking for an extra challenge, or just want a bit more action on your screen, you can manually launch those units. Now, from top-down view, I can strategically see where the units are coming from, where they're going to, and which areas of the battlefield aren't as covered as they should be. Now, Toy Soldiers HD, as the name suggests, is an HD remaster of the 2010 original, and this means that you will get all of the same fun and addictive historical gameplay, except with brand new visuals as well as all new content and all of the previously released DLC. I'm going to upgrade a unit here. I'm going to select it, select upgrade, it will turn over, and then after a period of time it will pop back up and it will be stronger than it was before. It will be level 2 in this instance, which will increase the power, reduce the reload speed and increase the fire rate. The enemy waves as the level progresses will get more and more difficult, so we've gone here from basic infantry into machine gunners. They are stronger, they have more health and take a little bit more time to kill, which means that there is more and more time for them to advance, and that is where the difficulty starts to creep in as we move through the levels. Moving away from ground-based combat, there is plenty of opportunity for aerial mayhem. There are various levels that will allow you to take control of an aircraft, whether that be a Sopwith Camel, a bomber, or indeed, if you're playing as the Germans, these red biplanes. Now, aerial combat is obviously very different to the ground-based combat, but it is just as much fun and there is plenty to do, whether it be head-to-head dogfighting, taking down these blimps for extra money and prizes, or taking aim at the target practice on the sides of the box. But don't get carried away and don't let your guard down with aerial levels, because do not forget that down below there is a battlefield and a toy box that you still need to defend. Moving on to one of the later levels, you will start to see that everything has ramped up quite considerably. The number of enemies, the amount of action, the size of units, but also the amount of strategy you will need and the amount of fun you will have. So diving down seamlessly into this flamethrower unit, you will notice that this bad boy is a great way to control a crowd. When you have advancing infantry coming so close to your toy box, this is one of those units that comes in really handy at taking back control when things look like they're about to go south. So here you'll see that the toy box is just to the right of this unit, and like I say, placing this at the entrance of the toy box is a great last line of defense. Again, switching between views from this environmental planning view into the third person action of this Mark 6, for example, is so satisfying. And we're gonna go to shell cam and boom. As you can see, we've also got vehicles in Toy Soldiers HD that you can commandeer and take control of. These will allow you to get up close and personal with the many weird and wonderful units that come your way. And the seamless transitions continue. So for example, I've noticed I'm missing a turret, so I'm going to drop out of the tank. We're gonna upgrade and I'm gonna be back in the tank, ready for some more action, all within a couple of seconds. It really is that seamless, it really is that simple, and it makes it so much fun to play. What else makes Toy Soldiers HD so much fun to play is that combination of strategy and action, and it's done so well. The ability to switch between views so seamlessly means that you don't have to hang around, and it means that your flow isn't interrupted. And things such as shell cam give you that extra dimension to be able to see the damage you're inflicting. As well as the air combat, the ground-based combat, and the vehicle combat, there is so much to sink your teeth into, and the replayability is huge. And that's not forgetting bosses. There are several bosses for you to encounter along the way, and this includes huge armored tanks, blimps, as well as armored trains. But you will need to use all of the tools at your disposal in order to defeat them before they destroy your toy box. You'll need to use a combination of aerial, ground, and vehicle attacks where possible, but you will need to be wise because a lot of your units will not stand up to direct contact with these bosses, so make sure you take them down before they get close. And to highlight just how tricky a boss can be, we're going to sit back and watch whether or not the K-Wagen can be defeated. Despite my best efforts, I wasn't good enough to be able to defeat the K-Wagen, and it completely obliterated my toy box. But hopefully you have better joy when Toy Soldiers HD comes out in 2021. It's coming for Xbox One, Nintendo Switch, PlayStation 4, and Steam. Enjoy.